mechanisms that have happened with the dealer banks, especially during the financial crisis, wherein they have encountered a lot of liquidity risk and even the solvency risk. So just trying to understand their major operations and what is contributing, what has contributed to each of these risks is something which we should look at now. So generally, when we understand the key operations of this large dealer banks, they provide some kind of intermediary services, right? They provide more and more of brokerage or intermediating kind of services. One in the OTC derivatives market, where they identify the counterparties, means they are actually playing a role where they are transferring the risk from one party to the other party. They are creating some kind of instruments or contracts, or they are mediating those contracts. Let's say interest rate swap. There is one party who wants to exchange a fixed interest with a floating interest. Now, there is a fixed rate payer. That party wants to identify who is a floating rate payer for getting into a such kind of an agreement. Now they approach the dealer bank, and dealer bank takes the responsibility of finding the counterparty and tying these two parties. So there is an intermediation service in the process, and because of that intermediation service, there is some fee or some kind of commission that is charged in the process. But what is happening in that is, there is a risk transfer from one party to the other party. Similarly, for the creation of CDOs, collateral debt obligations, or mortgage obligations, or loan obligations, whatever are the products, probably this dealer bank can create that product. But it is trying to link